Electrostatics, almost we have completed the chapter today. We'll discuss the last topic, dielectrics, before we move to dielectrics. Last question. 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 Either the electric field is zero or electric field is perpendicular. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So if I say the dipole is placed here, due to this dipole, the electric field here is perpendicular. But here, yes, the electric field is neither zero nor perpendicular.
Achha.
So my job is to make this electric field zero or perpendicular.
Yes, sir.
By some external field. So if I apply some external field like this, then I can make this electric field zero.
Yes, sir.
And in that case, this electric field will not be zero, but it is perpendicular. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Electric field is perpendicular or electric field zero. So can I say that both the conditions are satisfied at these points?
Yes, sir.
So I can say that it is a equipotential line. And I can say that this electric field naught is equal to the electric field at this position due to the dipole. Electric field is equal to the dipole, no. R by 2 for hollow hemisphere.
Yes, sir. R by 2.
Plus Q is here, minus Q is here. So what is the dipole moment? Q into R? Yes or no? Q is 2 pi R square into sigma. So the dipole moment is 2 pi sigma Q. Have you got it? Dipole moment?
Sir, R by 2 is equal to R by 2.
So center of mass is the way. Hollow hemisphere is center of mass. Hollow hemisphere. Center of mass R by 2 is the way. Check point away. First phase A. First phase A. First phase A. First phase A. Second phase A.
Second phase A.
So if hemisphere is good.
Equal to the hollow sphere. So in portion of the key. P vector is this one, E vector is given. So what is the torque of the electric field? Torque is
E sin theta.
Yes, E into sin theta. What is the angle between E vector and P vector?
37
degree. 37 degree. 53 degree. P into E sin 53 degree. Sin 53 degree 4 by 5. So 2 by sigma RQ E into 4 by 5. So what is the force by the electric field on that dipole?
Zero.
But electric field force like the
yes, sir.
But it has a torque. Due to torque, you have an angular acceleration. So you have a center of mass acceleration because equal to alpha. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So what is important in that acceleration, angular acceleration? Because this torque cannot, yes. This torque is about any point, right? This electric field cannot produce any acceleration because the net force is zero. So who is providing acceleration? Who is providing the force? The answer is friction, obviously, right? What is the direction of friction force? Even if you do not understand, if you do not know what is the direction, you can assume it to be anyways.
So in the direction of acceleration?
Yes, everything. In the direction of acceleration. In complicated equations, if you do not understand the direction of friction forward or backward, you can assume it to be any. And I write the equation about this point P if I take torque. Will the friction force matter about point P?
No, sir.
Talk about point P. What is talk about point P then? Friction is not producing any torque. Then what is talk about point P?
IP into alpha.
It is the same thing as tau E, yes or no?
Yes.
8 by 5, pi sigma R cube E. We have this question that this torque is about which point? Is the torque about center of mass? If the torque is about center of mass, why have I taken the same torque about P then? If the torque is about P, why have I taken the torque about center of mass like E then?
So, force to couple,
so the torque about any point is the same. They can talk about electric field about center of mass is away, about a point out. So that is equal to I alpha. What is I about P?
I by 3
mr square, right? Alpha. 2 by 3 mr square plus mr square. Parallel axis here. What is the value of alpha then? Alpha is equal to 24 by 25 m and pi sigma r e. Is it correct? Can I say as it is equal to motion, A equal to r alpha? Acceleration of the center of mass and alpha are related like this. Go to go. Will A equal to r alpha y? What is A? Now can I say that A is equal to according to my direction, F divided by m? Will you look at the value of minus F by m also? I mean, F by m. F by m is equal to r alpha is 24, pi sigma r square e divided by 25 m. M gets cancelled out, that will be the value of your friction force. 24 pi sigma r square e divided by 25. Force by electric field. What is the force? Dipole to same charge positive, same charge negative. That is, aero electric force E into Q, opposite direction. Aero electric force E into Q, shunted direction. That is, net force by electric field.
Zero.
Clear up to this? So we have a pretty good idea of what is electric dipole, what is torque on dipole, what is the electric field due to a dipole, what is the potential due to a dipole, each and everything we have discussed. Now the topic we will discuss is dielectrics. Dielectrics, have a look.
Sir, dipole start with equation that I have given.
Dipole started again. Okay, so everything is clear up to this. Now we'll go to the dielectrics. Dielectrics is only a same thing as that of a non-conductor, right? It is a fancy way of saying dielectrics, right? Non-conductor and dielectrics are the same thing. What happens when external electric field is applied to any non-conductor? That we will discuss now, right? We know that whenever external field is applied to a metal or conductor, what happens to the inside electric field? If the metal is applied to the inside electric field, then the inside electric field is zero. Dielectrics is negative, inside electric field is zero. right? কি করে বোঝাতে চাও? So dielectrics are non-conductors where charges are bound, not free to move like the conductor. Two types of dielectrics are there. One is a non-polar dielectric, another is a polar dielectric. Non-polar dielectric where the negative charges are uniformly surrounded about around positive charge, such that the center's coincide. You will not find any net dipole moment. So the AC center net electric dipole, you will find zero. Because positive and negative charges center to the center. Right? So dipole moment is not there. For example, HCl, H plus and Cl minus. There is a slight difference between the centers of Cl minus and H plus. Right? So in this molecule, there is a net dipole moment from negative to positive. There is a net dipole moment per molecule. So this is a polar molecule and this is a non-polar molecule. Right? In polar molecule, there is a net dipole moment, non-polar, no net dipole moment. When in normal ordinary case, if I see a volume of these two dielectrics, at a block, I polar block, there is no dipole moment. Polar case, if you have a block, then there are few dipole moments. But they are randomly arranged so that in the net volume, in any unit volume, you will find the net dipole moment to be zero. Can you understand this thing?
Last diagram.
আমি বললাম যদি একটা পোলার মলিকুলের একটা ভলিউম নাও তাহলে দেখবে যদিও এদের ইউনিট মলিকুলের ডাইপোল মোমেন্ট আছে কিন্তু প্রত্যেকটা ডাইপোল মোমেন্টগুলো আরবিটারি হ্যাপাসাকি অ্যারেঞ্জ মানে একটা ক্যান্সেল করে দিচ্ছে নেট ডাইপোল মোমেন্ট
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে
what happens if I apply some external electric field to the dielectric so suppose this is a polar and non polar molecule right and this is a polar volume and this is a non polar set right now when I apply external electric field what happens to the polar molecule the polar molecules which were earlier neutral earlier means their centers coincide now their centers will polarize yes or no electric field কে নেগেটিভ চার্জ হয়ে যাবে পজিটিভ চার্জ কে নেগেটিভ চার্জ হয়ে যাবে নেগেটিভ চার্জ হলো ইলেকট্রন উল্টো হয়ে যাবে তাহলে এখন আমি এটার ভিতর থেকে একটা নেট ডাইপোল মোমেন্ট পাবো polar molecule আগে থেকেই ডাইপোল ছিল ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড অ্যাপ্লাই করলে polar molecule গুলো একই দিকে অ্যারেঞ্জ হয়ে যাবে দ্য ডাইপোল মোমেন্টস উইল নাও নট বি হ্যাপাসাকি অ্যারেঞ্জ বাট দ্য ডাইপোল মোমেন্টস উইল বি অ্যারেঞ্জ ইন দ্য সেম ডিরেকশন what I will now get is a net dipole moment is created inside the volume of this blocks বুঝা গেল এই সিচুয়েশন কি হচ্ছে
সো দিস ইজ ইট ইফ
ইউ অ্যাপ্লাই সাম ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড হ্যাপেন্স টু দ্য polar molecule দেন ইট গেটস অ্যারেঞ্জ রাইট লাইক ইট গেটস সো আই উইল গেট আ ডাইপোল মোমেন্ট পলিস মোমেন্ট নাও উইল গেট আ ডাইপোল মোমেন্ট নাও দিস ডাইপোল মোমেন্টস আর অ্যারেঞ্জ ইন কেস অফ polar molecule আর দ্য ডাইপোল মোমেন্টস হ্যাপাসাকি অ্যারেঞ্জ বাট নাও দ্য এক্সটার্নাল ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড প্রোডিউস আ টর্ক ইনসাইড দেম সো ইফ দ্য টর্ক ইজ देयर डेफिनेटली উইল অ্যারেঞ্জ ইন এভরি সিঙ্গল ওয়ে কারণ দ্য ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড So these were two different situations, but different molecules, non-polar and polar, but after application of external electric field, the situation becomes the same. Now my task is to calculate the negative field inside the dielectric. In dielectric, the negative field is calculated. How to do that? Let us take a block of dielectrics. You can see that as soon as I apply some external electric field, its faces will have this positive and negative charges. Actually, how these positive and negative charges are arising on the face? Due to this dipole, you can see this dipole, one dipole is minus plus, just next dipole is minus plus, just next dipole is minus plus like this. These points are very close. I can cancel them. What net effect can I say? Can I say that in net effect, this face will have a negative charge and this face will have a positive charge? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Only admit
এই ব্লকের ভিতরে এই ব্লকের ভিতরে একটা ডাইপোল তৈরি হয়েছে এই ডাইপোল গুলো এই যে ডাইপোল তৈরি হয়েছে ডাইপোল নেগেটিভ পজিটিভ আছে হ্যাঁ ডাইপোল গুলো নেগেটিভ পজিটিভ আছে তারপর ডাইপোল নেগেটিভ পজিটিভ আছে এইভাবে লাস্ট ডাইপোল নেগেটিভ পজিটিভ আছে তাহলে সেটা করে আমি ফাইনাল দেখলাম এখানে একটা পজিটিভ চার্জ আছে এখানে নেগেটিভ চার্জ আছে তাহলে এই ব্লকের ভিতরে কি কি ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড তৈরি হলো ভালো করে দেখো তিন রকমের দুই রকমের ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড ব্লকে তৈরি হলো কি রকম ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড ওয়ান ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড ইজ ডিউ টু ইনডিউস চার্জেস ইজ নো দ্যাটস ইট ওয়াট ইজ দ্য ফিল্ড ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড
থ্যাংক ইউ
ইয়েস
ইট শুড বি অপোজিট টু ইয়েস
অপোজিট টু ইয়েস প্লাস অর মাইনাস আর ইয়েস ইজ দেয়ার ইনসাইড সো ইফ আই গেট আ সুপারপজিশন অফ ইয়েস এন্ড ই ইনডিউস দেন আই ক্যান গেট আ নেগেটিভ ফিল্ড ইজ নো So that is happening here. E external is like this. E induced is like this. Their addition is in it. This cannot be zero in case of dielectrics. This is zero in case of conductors. In case of dielectric, the net electric field is always less than E external. Obviously, it is less than E external, but the net electric field is never zero.
Sir, so, E induced means dipole moment.
Yeah. Induced, E charge goes zero in case of dielectric. Electric field applied, positive charge induced.
Okay.
I think it is clear up to this. If you have any doubt, you can ask me now. Because now we will talk about the net electric field. Tell me, if induced electric field, if the net electric field increases, what about induced electric field? It should increase or it should decrease?
Decrease.
If I increase the net electric field, does that mean that external electric field has to increase? Yes or no? Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
If I increase the E external, then E net will increase?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But if I increase the E external, will the induced charges increase or decrease?
Increase.
It will increase?
Increase.
Polarization will increase. If I increase the external electric field, polarization will increase. So if polarization increases, then induced electric field will increase or decrease?
Increase. Increase.
Increase. So by the way, if you see E net and E induced, they are inversely proportional or directly proportional?
Directly.
Yeah. If you increase E net, that means you are increasing E external, you are increasing the polarization charges and you are increasing the induced. So E induced is directly proportional to E net, remember. If you are increasing E net, you cannot increase E net by reducing E induced. You have to increase the induced.
Have
you got it? Sir, E external increase, E external increase, the difference constant? No, because the rate of E external
increase,
E external increase, okay? So, that if the E induced is proportional to E net, the proportional constant is known as susceptibility of the material. Remember it? Susceptibility is denoted by this sign pi, like X, it is written as X, right? Slightly curvy, this is sign slightly curvy. So this is called pi, this one, this is symbol. So induced electric field and E net, they are related with the factor pi. Induced electric field is proportional to E net. So what is the external electric field? It is E, what is the net electric field? It is E external minus E induced. You take E induced in the left side, I will take E net to be common. So I can say E net into 1 plus pi equal to E external. Yes or no? Can I say E net equal to E external by 1 plus pi? And 1 plus pi, this constant is known as dielectric constant, or the relative permittivity of the medium. Have you got it? So this is a lengthy calculation. I don't want you to remember each and everything. You can only remember this is the most important equation that you should remember from this topic of dielectrics. That E net is equal to external electric field divided by the dielectric constant. And dielectric constant has a relation of susceptibility which is 1 plus pi. Okay? This is not a syllabus of J advanced, but I don't know why J means very frequently asked questions on these things. Just this year also they have asked questions on susceptibility. So if you remember this equation, it will be easy for you to answer this question. Right? 1 plus pi is equal to dielectric constant. E net is equal to E external divided by K. Right? This year I think they asked this question that what is the susceptibility of a metal conductor? Can you tell me what is the susceptibility of a metal conductor?
So 1.
is it 1?
Infinity.
It is infinity, yes. Susceptibility of metal conductor is infinity.
Infinity,
and if you know the relation of pi and k, you can easily answer this question. 1 plus pi is equal to k. Okay? Now the dielectric constant, is 1 plus pi, right? So the E net is equal to E external divided by this dielectric constant. Another term is their polarization, although they have not asked any question about polarization till it, but who knows, they can ask any time. Polarization vector is the net dipole moment per unit volume. You can see that there are so many dipole moments are generated here. What is the dipole moment per unit volume? Right, for that, what I will do? I will take the surface charge density of this induced charges as sigma here. Can you tell me what is the E induced in terms of sigma? What is E induced in terms of sigma? You can assume this to be infinite plates. So this is sigma by epsilon not only. If you remember the formula, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the net dipole moment of the system inside the volume? If I ask you what is the net dipole moment, what should be your answer? Net dipole moment?
Sigma by A into D.
Sigma A into D. Good. Net dipole moment is sigma A into D. A into sigma is the charge multiplied with D is the net dipole moment. Right? Answer. So net dipole moment, sigma A into D. What is the dipole moment per unit volume then?
By D.
Is it the sigma?
Yes, sir.
And is it epsilon not into E induced?
Yes, yes, sir.
What is the direction of this dipole moment?
It is minus 2 plus.
Minus 2 plus opposite to E induced?
Yes, sir.
That is why I have written this polarization vector. Dipole moment per unit volume, which is epsilon into E induced, but the direction is opposite. Right? I can anytime replace the induced to be 1 to k minus 1 into E net. Right? Or pi into E net. And here the dipole moment, the polarization vector is the same direction as the E net. So I can write epsilon not into k minus 1 into E net.
Sir, susceptibility
is a very similar way to express the dielectric constant. Dielectric constant will say that how easily the electric field lines can move inside the material. Right? If it is infinite, you are saying that that no electric field lines are going to move inside them. Right? Like if it is a metal, then electric field lines, it is not allowing electric field lines to go inside them. So that is why you are saying that this value is infinite. Right? It is a resistivity basically. It is a resistance of the electric field lines, you can say, in the, to pass the medium. And susceptibility is a very similar thing because one is a constant, so they are related with one only. Susceptibility, if you talk about susceptibility, then actually this term, why these two different constants are used? Because when you will see electromagnetic waves, basically susceptibility are used in that case. That is why there is the use of that susceptibility. Otherwise, both are the same constant, right? Their physical significance are the same. Any more doubt from this particular topic? You need to remember each and every equation with respect to E net. E induced equal to pi into E net, E external equal to k into E net, and polarization equal to epsilon k minus 1 into E net. Understood this one?
Yes.
Now, another very important thing is modified Gauss law. Okay, now suppose I give you this situation where this is a block of dielectrics. I say that if I apply external electric field, find the net electric field by Gauss law. You can say that, no, I know the net electric field. The net electric field is E external by K. I know that you know that net electric field is E external by K. But once, if you forget whatever you have studied, I want to find E net from Gauss law, not the equations that you have studied. What you will do? You will probably take a Gaussian surface like this. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And if I try to write down a Gaussian, the Gauss law in this surface, in this cylindrical surface, try to understand that carefully. In that cylindrical surface, what should I write as Gauss law?
So, electric field out in E out into ds minus E into ds equals to Q delta E into Q.
So E outside contain E net?
Yeah.
Into delta S minus?
Ex.
Into delta S. Equal to Kiliko?
Equal to delta S.
Equal to sigma delta S by epsilon.
Yes.
Right, if it is a negative charge, you know beforehand, you can write it like this. No problem. But the question is again the same. Can I find E net from this Gauss law? Because I don't have any idea about sigma also. I don't know what is the induced charge density. Then, can you find the value of E net from this particular equation? Yes or no? No, that's definitely not. If I do not know what is the value of sigma. What is sigma here? By the way, what is sigma?
Yes, induced charge density.
In no question, you will be given induced charge density. No question about induced charge density. Because people are least interested about induced charge. Question ki baat hai, you will remember the questions, whatever you have done. Shell A is given a charge Q, shell B is given a charge Q. One question mentioned about the induced charge on shell B is minus Q, induced charge on shell C. Nowhere it will be mentioned.
Now the dielectric constant terms
is not into chi into E
section. Okay, again, but for that you have to move back to the previous expressions that you have done. Right? If you know what is the relation between sigma and E net, you can probably find the answer. Yes or no? Yeah, let us try to do it. E net minus EX is equal to minus, what is sigma? Sigma by epsilon naught is equal to E induced, yes or no? Sigma by epsilon naught is E induced?
Yes, yes.
And what is E induced? The relation between E induced and E net?
Chi into E net.
If you take chi in this side, what do you get? 1 plus chi into E net
equal to
EX. So what is the value of E net? EX.
Okay.
Gauss is very applicable here also, no problem in that. But my question is that here I know that what is the relation between sigma and E net. That is why we have solved it in this way. Can I get a direct formula where I do not, even if I do not know the relation of sigma and E net and everything, I can write directly the equation. That is not as modified Gauss. Modified Gauss says that, look at this equation. What is 1 plus chi? It is the dielectric constant. Where the dielectric constant is K? Inside. What is the dielectric constant outside? What is the dielectric constant? 1. Can I say this is equal to 0? That is what I have written here. Yes or no?
Yes.
So instead of E dot ds, Gauss law says integral of E dot ds is equal to Q inside divided by epsilon. Modified Gauss law says instead of writing E dot ds, you write K into E dot ds. What should I get in the left right side? The right side, it will be independent of the induced charge. The right side is only dependent on the extraneous charge. What is extraneous charge? The charge that you have put from outside or external source. Charge supplied from external source. এইটা আসলে বাউন্ড চার্জ দিস বাই দা ইনডিউসড চার্জ আমি এটা বাইরে থেকে সাপ্লাই করিনি এই সিগমাটি বাইরে থেকে সাপ্লাই করা হয়েছিল না ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ডের ইনডাকশন এফেক্টের জন্য সিগমাটা তৈরি হয়েছে মডিফাইড গস ল ডাজ নট টেক দোজ চার্জেস ইনটু অ্যাকাউন্ট দ্যাট ইজ ওয়াই ইট ইজ ইম্পর্টেন্ট টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড মডিফাইড গস ল বিকজ সামটাইমস ইন মোস্ট অফ দা কেসেস ইউ ডু নট হ্যাভ আ আইডিয়া অফ দা ইনডিউসড চার্জেস বাট দা এক্সটারনালি পুট চার্জ উইল বি ক্লিয়ারলি মেনশন ইন ইকুয়েশন দে ব্লকে তো এটা এক্সটারনাল চার্জ দেওয়া আছে তাই তো আমি মডিফাইড
স্যার বলো স্যার
এক্সটারনালস মানে এক্সটারনাল চার্জ এই সিস্টেমে বাইরে থেকে এক্সটারনাল চার্জ দেওয়া
হয়েছে হ্যাঁ দেওয়া
হয়েছে কোনটা কত চার্জ দেওয়া হয়েছে কোনটা সেকেন্ডে
দেওয়া হয়েছে স্যার এটা তো দেওয়া হয়েছে মানে ইনডিউসড
বাইরে থেকে দেওয়া হয়েছে তাহলে আমি এখানে জিরো বসিয়েছি Right. Now, the equation is k into e net, 8.8 dielectric constant k into e net minus 1 into e external into delta s. Can I say this is k into e dot delta s that I have written in this website?
Yes, sir.
That is equal to 0. Why? Because in this case, there is no external charge. In the same question, you have mentioned for some unit volume in this dielectric, there is a charge of charge density rho present. Externally, I mean dielectric k, rho density diye charge kore rekhechi. Tarpor jokhon electric field apply korlam, tokhon eta kon value hobe external electric field. Ki value korbo? Tokhon ei volume er bhitore kotota external charge ache seta amake bolte hobe. Tokhon kothay koto induced charge hocche that is all.
Sir, please repeat something.
Suppose I say there is a block, dielectric block, right? And the dielectric block has uniform charge density rho. Okay, so if the volume I know, what is the total charge, I can find it. Right, uniform charge density is there in this dielectric slab. Now I ask you that I apply some external electric field in this space. What will be the value of E net inside electric field? Suppose I have distance x from this space. What is the value of electric field inside? This is my question. How to solve this question? Look, if you try to solve this question, you can use E equal to external by k here. E equal to external by k equation use kotha parbo na. Karon E equal to external by k kokhon hoto? Jokhon shudhumatro induced charge ar external charge net effect ami E net hoyeche. How do you do that? You can say that I use Gauss's law. No problem. You can use this surface and you can use Gauss's law. What is the equation that you write in Gauss's
law? E into E net minus E x.
E to ds minus E external into ds equal to kilipe. Is the Gauss's right? Gauss's law mana ache? A surface ke plus positive E dot ds. A surface plus 2k E into delta s negative. That is equal to what you write.
U inside by epsilon.
Now what is U inside?
Delta s into E.
Gauss's law mana ache? Gauss's law. Gauss's law. Gauss's law. Gauss's law. Gauss's law.
Rho x by epsilon. Rho x by epsilon.
You are saying that U inside is equal to rho x by
epsilon.
Yes or no? Yes, sir. I'm saying this is not the U inside.
Induced charge.
Yes, there is all induced charge. Why are you making that? This induced charge is not there.
Yes, sir.
But do you have any idea what is the induced charge present here?
No, sir.
Then how to solve this question? Then I don't have any other way to solve this question. But modified Gauss law, what does it say? Modified Gauss law says instead of E dot ds, you write k into E dot ds. So what is k here? K, I'm saying. What is k outside?
One
into E dot ds.
One.
Yes. One I think that is not working. Just give me a moment.
Yes.
Let's see now. It was. So we were talking about modified Gauss law, and we have seen that if I put some external charge, then it is difficult for me to calculate the net charge inside because I don't have any idea of what is. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yes, good. So I was saying that in modified Gauss law, I can calculate the E net. If suppose this is the box and I have kept rho density charge inside it from external source, and if someone asks you what is the electric field inside at a distance x from it, what do you say? That you will take a Gaussian surface like this, then this is the E external and this is the E net. Right? Now the charge inside E net, Q inside, is not equal to only rho into delta s into x, but also the charge induced is involved in it. And I don't have any idea about induced charges. So modified Gauss law helps us. How do I use the modified Gauss law? K into E net. Minus, what is the dielectric constant here outside? 1 into E external. Now what should I write? Now what should I write as 1 by epsilon 1 into Q inside? What Q inside I will write now?
Rho delta x.
Yes, this is the extraneous charge. Right? This is extraneous charge. Now can you understand what is extraneous?
Yes.
Rho delta x divided by, this is delta x by epsilon 1. So modified Gauss law will help you calculate the E net. But from Gauss law, you cannot use this one. Gauss law, you can say delta s into E net minus E external. That is total Q inside by epsilon 1. But I don't have any idea about Q inside like this. I don't have any idea of this. So modified Gauss law helps you to calculate the electric field inside in case of dielectrics.
Sorry,
can I explain? Xij, can I say, equation to the
electric.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is written here, external charge. Now let's solve one of the question. The first question is this one. In the diagram shown, find the value of E1 equal to E4. Suppose this is external electric field E. What is E1 there? E1 value of
E by K1.
What is the E2?
E by K2.
E2 will be E by K2, not E1 by K2. Remember that. Because it depends on external charge, external field. Right? Before entering the slab 2, the electric field has to come out of slab 1. When it comes out of slab 1, the electric field can see. Right? E3 is equal to?
E by K3.
And what is E4?
E.
Also, it is asking for the energy stored inside the dielectric slab if the surface area is A, suppose. What is energy stored inside that volume? Remember, it is half K into epsilon into E net square. It is energy density now, yes, into 81, right? Energy density earlier, we have put half epsilon E square. Here, it is half K epsilon E square, right? It is half K epsilon E2 square. Similarly, it is half k epsilon is. Clear this one?
Second answer.
যখন তুমি এই চার্জ থেকে বাইরে চলে আসছো তখন কি এই দুটো কোনো এফেক্ট থাকবে না তাহলে আমি ইলেকট্রিক ফিল্ড কি নেব ইনেবল electric field and polarization at a distance x from the center of a solid dielectric sphere of radius r having uniform charge density rho and constant k. So we have already done this question previously. So, do you remember what is the electric field inside a solid sphere?
Yes.
Yeah, we have used only the dielectric constant v1.
Yes,
sir. Can you tell me what is the dielectric
constant?
Wait, do that. You want to solve
it?
Here we did a spherical shell. Here we
did
a spherical shell. Here we did a
spherical shell. Here we did a spherical shell.
Q inside double total. Q inside. What is Q inside?
So, going to 4 by 3
pi. Is that going to 4 by 3 pi Q?
Yes.
Is that correct? No.
Plus Q inside
right, plus Q new. This is Q inside. So, ordinary Gauss law will not have to solve this question, yes or no?
Yes.
So, rather I will use modified Gauss law. Yes or no? If I use modified Gauss law, then I will use that here the electric field is supposed E. Here the electric field is E. So, can I say integral of K E dot ds? Is equal to Q, what should I write? Inside or the extraneous?
Extraneous.
Extraneous charge. Good. Q extraneous. Divide by epsilon naught. Now E into K dot ds means 4 pi x square is equal to rho into 4 third pi x cube divided by epsilon naught. 4 pi x square you can cancel. So the electric field is rho x by key K epsilon naught. Have you got it?
Yes, sir.
What is the polarization vector? Do you remember the formula of polarization?
So minus K into minus
K. Epsilon naught K minus 1 into E. Right? So it is epsilon into E is rho x by key K into K minus 1. Yes or no? For outside, I can say what is K for outside?
1
into E dot ds. Total charge extraneous means the total charge I will see here. Yes or no?
Yes.
4 third pi r cube rho divided by epsilon naught. So the outside field won't change, it remains the same. Right? It is rho r cube divided by 3 epsilon x square. What is outside polarization vector? What is outside polarization?
0.
0. As K is 0. So outside there will be no polarization. Only
K,
K is equal to 1, sorry. Yes. Pi equal to 1 plus K minus 1, right? Pi, 1. 1 plus pi equal to K is. K equal to 1. Pi equal to 0. And polarization is equal to 0 because K is 1. Have you understood this modified Gauss law, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. So, I conclude this chapter in electrostatics. we will talk about capacitors. That capacitor is a topic that is combination of electrostatic as well as current electricity. Like sometimes charges can flow, sometimes charges are at rest. So we will talk about capacitors after the current electricity, then it will be better and easier to understand the properties and different equations involving capacitors. Right? So in few books, they first study capacitors, then they can study capacitors in current electricity. We will cover this after current electricity. And also, I think that we have done a lot of things where charges are at rest. So now to deviate from the concept where charges are at rest, now we will try to understand what will happen if charges are in motion, right? If charges are moving. And this current electricity chapter is a chapter which you have means you are studying from your lower class physics, I think from the 7 or 8. You are studying what is series resistance, parallel resistance, what is the current to them, what is the potential difference. So I think students in class 10th or 9th, you don't have any idea about electrostatics physically, how this potential difference is being generated, right? You don't have any idea how this current is flowing, how this electric field is created, how the potential difference is created, right? But you have idea about what is current, right? What is the potential difference V equal to IR? Then you have idea calculation based, you can do all these calculations. But electrostatics actually helps us understand the basic. Now we talk about current electricity. Right? Current electricity, as you know, that when charges will flow, which charges will flow? Now, if I place another nucleus, as the metals are very congested inside, so the atoms are very close. So, the influence on this electron, is not only due to this atom, but this nucleus will also influence this electron, yes or no? Right?
Yes. Yes.
Similarly, this will also influence the electron. That way, you can say that what is the which atom actually this electron belongs to? The answer is all three of them. So, the electron can flow everywhere inside the potential difference, inside a particular potential range or energy range. That is how the free electron concept is generated. Free electron means atom electron If the electron is here, the energy is suppose 10.2 electron volt. If the electron is here, the energy is different. Suppose it is something different, 13.6 electron volt. But here, if the electron, I have a range of electrons energy, 10.2 to 13.6. Now the electron can move inside this range. So here the electron is possible. The electron is possible to be here. The electron is possible to be here. The metal makes a range of the energy rather than a discrete energy of electron. Have you understood this concept?
So, metals. Main atom has a particular range of electrons.
Electrons at a particular range of electrons. Electrons have a range of electrons. This J is current density, E is electric field. And what is sigma? Sigma is known as conductivity in E into mu. Right, so several things are there. If you have to remember something, then this is, these are the equations that I need to remember. Right, this is the equation you can remember. J equal to... Yeah. Current equal to NVDA, I can think about it. Current area divide by me, I can J vector define column. Yeah, current density. Current density, same direction, current decay, magnitude I by A. So, current density and E direction, same, and E are current direction, same. Either the relation of N into E equal to J, N into mu is equal to sigma, I mean, that I assume. Sigma is conductivity of the area. Area vector, no. So, J dot DS, this is area vector, you can see here.
Yes, sir.
This is a vector. This is a vector. This one is a vector. But when I'm dividing I by A, this was scalar, right? This I'm only taking the magnitude of I by A. Right? But when you multiply J with area, both are vectors, then only when you are talking about, you are taking a scalar. Okay? And what is the direction of area vector? As I told you, the direction of area vector will be perpendicular to A. Yes, no? The same thing is here. Let me get this in doubt. Now, one more thing you have to understand. Suppose the cross-section area of the metal conductor is varying. The cross-section area of varicose. What should I write about this equation? Look, can I say, I'm talking about the magnitudes only. The electric field equal to D by DX, can I write it?
Yes, sir, minus D by DS.
Minus D by DS, obviously, but I know the direction. I know the direction of the field, so I only get the magnitude here. Right? So what is J? J equal to sigma into E. Can I write instead of sigma into E, sigma into D by DS?
Yes, sir.
So what is the current? From this expression, can I say current equal to dV divided by rho dx by AX? What is rho? Rho is the resistivity. Rho is the resistivity. 1 by sigma. 1 by conductivity or resistivity. 1 by conductivity is resistivity. So current equal to dV by rho dx by AX. Can you relate this equation from here? Just tell me.
Yes, sir.
What is dV here? Can you tell me what is dV?
Dx is across the potential
difference. Dv is the potential difference across dV. Yes. But do I know? What is the potential difference across this point? Or I know what is potential difference across this point? Do I know delta V or do I know dV? Which one will be given in your question?
Delta V.
So let us integrate this numerator as well as denominator. When I integrate the numerator, what I will get?
Delta V.
When I integrate the denominator, what I will get is the resistance. Right. Now there is an obvious question that should come to your mind. That I have got this equation. So this current, what is this current? Is that current through this small segment only? Yes or no?
So current should be through the conductor.
Yes. But I am saying that even if I integrate it, this current will remain the same. Can you tell me why the current is same everywhere in the conductor? Even I am using this equation, or someone is using this equation, someone is using this equation. Any cross section, if you use the same equation, you will find the same current. Why the current is same in every cross section? Yes, because the conductor cannot produce or absorb charges. So if I say, suppose, at certain instant, 100 number of electrons are crossing this surface area per second. After some time, when this electron reaches the surface, what will be the number of electrons that will cross that surface? Will that number be 100 more than
100
or less than 100? 100 only. So if the number of charges crossing per second remains same, does it matter which area you are saying, or the number remains the same, the current remains the same?
So can we relate this to the equation of continuity?
Yes, it's the same thing. Equation of continuity is the same. So I can say that the current is equal to integral of dV divided by integral of this one. Right? If you have the idea of what is dV, you can use this equation also. You find the same current. But in most of the cases, I don't have idea of dV. I have given value of delta V. What is resistance? Resistance is equal to rho dx by dx, right? What is dx? Dx is the direction of current. Direction of current, how much has moved, and area is the particular direction of current. What is the area? Right? If the area is a constant, I can take it outside the formula by A. Otherwise, I will use this equation. Right? This equation is also very famous. I'm sure you all know that. Delta V equal to IR, where the resistance is a constant. V is proportional to I. Okay. All right. So, I'll end the class for today. Already 120 is there. We can start the next class from here. But I again suggest you to go through the entire relation that we have done. Right? I'll leave one or two questions for your practicing homework. All right. So, this question, I'll leave you one question. Try these two questions and next class will start from there. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So, what do you have a test next weekend?